very good. We are all here for peace. So don't worry about your microphones. We're not going to say anything strange.
Lights, please. Thank you.
This way.
Thank you to the open door, please.
No.
Let's go, please. You don't want to get in.
All right.
Anyone want to first?
No way.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Participate yourself in the peace process.
We're not going to take any questions. We have meetings coming up in which all of these things are going to be discussed, so I won't take any questions.
Nice, please. Thank you.
Okay. Hello, Sunshava. Hello.
Hello.
Now, I've been telling the President that, well, very pleased we all are to see you back in Washington after almost 3 years. And now I can say congratulations on your re-election on Egypt's successes in the Arab world following the Amman summit. I think one of the proudest achievements as president has been strengthening, on my part, the U.S.-Egyptian partnership. And I think we've accomplished a great deal together, and there are many challenges that lie ahead of us. And I also much appreciation for your kind words on the INF Treaty. We're determined to move forward on arms control. And I learned just one phrase in Russian that I could use and did use frequently in my meetings with the General Secretary. Dovyai no proviai. It means trust but verify.
Yes.
Back to the place where he began to get a little annoyed. Well, we've engaged them on a broad range of issues. We're watching closely for signs that they're all serious about taking constructive steps. We think the two key tests will be in Afghanistan and the Persian Gulf. A comprehensive settlement of the Palestinian problem remains a very high priority, as the President and I have been talking in the other room about this. And the recent violence in the West Bank and Gaza only underscores the dangers of what's going on and the need for practical steps toward negotiations. I understand the problems created for you by the events in the territories and applaud your statesmanlike attitude with regard to them. You have a unique role as a bridge between the Arab world and Israel, and together we might build a collective approach to generate progress. You can use your channels to Israel and Jordan and the Palestinians and other Arabs to press for serious dialogue and substantial issues and not just rhetorical posturing. Your call for a cooling off period and breathing space to prepare ground for making progress also very sensible. Continued violence like this to bring up.
That's one of the same points I have on my agenda. You've already mentioned, Mr. President, but I'd like to thank you very much for inviting me again here, giving me the good opportunity to discuss with you and your associates all these problems. And really, I value our friendship, that which exists between our two peoples. This is very important, and